and gentlemen, welcome to a new video. My name is Roy, and today I'll be reacting to the Dutch national selection for Junior Eurovision 2022. We'll be having four songs in the competition. They are Never Ever, It Doesn't Matter, La Festa, and Because I Know. The selection is going to be in a few weeks' time, and we will know who will represent us in Eurovision. As you might know, I'm Dutch. I don't really like the Junior Eurovision way of selecting a song. In the Netherlands, they usually don't produce the best of songs. They're very basic. But keep in mind that most of the comments I'll be making in this video are about the song producers, not about the kids singing the songs, because one, they're kids, their voices haven't fully developed yet, so who knows where it goes. Two, they're kids. Three, they're kids. Like, literally, it's just a dream to perform on a big stage. They have this opportunity now. Who wouldn't be excited? I would be. I know that for sure. So also in the comments, if you leave a comment, be respectful. They're kids, okay? Be respectful. I know most of you are respectful usually, but just pointing it out again. Yeah, I think it's everything I had to mention. There are a few other national selections, I think, for Junior, and it's all heating up, so we'll get to those as well. But today, we go into the Netherlands. So without further ado, let's jump straight into the first song. The first song that I will be reacting to is by the girl group, Infinity. It seems to be four girls from the picture I see right now, and this song is called Never Ever. Yeah, let's find out what it is about, and let's click play! Oh, I miss doing these videos, you know. Okay. Simple guitar riff. Okay, adding some drums to it immediately. Oh! Gonna be drum and bass? What was the other part? I had a dream! Okay, actually, this is already a little bit better than I'm used to from the Netherlands. Usually it's like, oh, it completely sounds like you open a register with basic beat 2.0. You grabbed it, gave it to the kids, and they sing to it. But now it seems like they actually properly use the instruments well and like introduce new instruments in the right times. It will still be quite a bit of a basic song, I guess, but not too bad. And a good thing for the girls as well, their four voices fit very well together, especially like on this studio cut. Of course, we don't know how it will be live, but it sounds really coherent. That all four have a very clear voice and it fits the song. And it kind of fits the trend of pop music. I mean, it was maybe a little bit of a trend like a year ago or something, that you give a bit more rock into the songs. That's really what we've been seeing. And even maybe with Junior, that might be a trend that can develop. What I do hope is that they don't put them in Ahoy again, because that was way too big of an arena for their voices. Like was it last year in Ahoy as well? I think so. It all sounded super empty in the live performance, and wasn't the best to judge on, I guess. Yeah! Is that it? I think so, right? Yeah! Honestly, that's a good start. I enjoyed that quite a bit. Good. Nice. Never Ever from Infinity. Nice start. Let's go to the next one. The next song is by the four-headed group. Mixed Up, it's two guys and two girls, I think. It Doesn't Matter is the name of the song, and yeah, it's interesting because they upload the songs 1 week after another, and this already has exactly the same amount of views as the one we just listened to, so it makes me a little bit hyped. Maybe that's a false sense of security or something. I don't know. We'll find out, and let's listen to this song. Let's click play! Okay. They're going to more of a vocal chop route, maybe? She has a shh thingy. I don't know how it's called in Dutch. Or in English. I know it's slissing. That's okay, but oh, it's definitely gonna be some dance song. Oh! Yeah! Let's go! The claps, yep. And then boom. It is predictable, like the formula isn't new or anything. But that doesn't really matter for Junior as much. Like, I think in Adult Eurovision you need something more unique, maybe. And Junior is more like, oh, that's fun, I'm gonna vote for it. She has a bit of a folk singer sound to her voice for some reason, I don't know. I am genuinely enjoying this. I hope they can nail it live, to be honest. This would fit the trend of the Dochi is going for a dancer. Like, this would fit right in what we're good at, basically. She has such an interesting voice. Like, there's like this accent that like kind of reminds me of some foy or like folk singers in the Netherlands. It's kind of cool. I mean, the formula for all the songs will generally be the same. But it does seem so far that we got a bit of a wake-up call last year, and that's good. Very good. We need to do better, because last year, it wasn't even that bad. Like, I've had worse years, but... Yeah, the songs weren't very well produced necessarily last year. I enjoyed that one. That was really good. That could be a good entry, honestly. It is what we're good at, that we've seen in the past, you know, it's an up-tempo, like a very fun song performed by a group. It's really what we're good at, and could do well, I'm not gonna lie. Very much a thumbs up from me. So, let's go to the next one. The third song is by Luna, and the song is called La Festa, which is interesting because it is not a title in English or Dutch. Yeah, last year we had, of course, the title in Japanese, Matsuke Aone, something like that. I'm not good at Japanese or anything, so yeah. Anyways, curious where it goes. La Festa said, I think, like, the party or something, so it must be up-tempo, I would guess. Or a very sad ballad, like, oh, everybody's having fun and at the party and not me. Anyways, I'm going way off the trail. I haven't heard a single note yet, and I'm already rambling. Yes, Luna La Festa. Let's click play. Ballad? Okay. Dramatic bass. It reminds me of a song. I can't put my finger on it what it is, but it reminds me of a song. Okay. Yo, honestly, you improved. These songs are all better than what we had last year, so that's good. Like, genuinely, if you look back at the videos I made last year and the year before, I think most of the commentary I made was, oh, we just open a register, pick out a song.exe, use it for this. But these sounds, like, they actually took the effort to make something better, a bit more unique, a bit cooler. Like, this is a really cool way to structure the song. Enjoy it. I'm not sure if she'll be able to carry the richness of her voice in live performance. Like, I think live it might sound a bit too empty for it to really stand out, especially compared to the other two. Because you have four voices in those. But hey, this is really fun again. I think I prefer this one less than the other two. But I really applaud them for going the way they went with this. Wow. I keep forgetting the name of that brass instrument, I'm sorry. I should really learn to distinguish brass instruments more, because, yeah, it's not my forte just yet. I'll work on that, I promise. La Festa. Yes, yes. Yeah, like I said, it was really enjoyable. It's something a lot different than what you usually see in the Netherlands. In our selection, at least. So, I really enjoyed that. Good. I'm glad they kind of take, not necessarily a big risk, but they take a bit more of a risk with the production of the song. It's just not as basic as it sometimes was. Which is good, because I think so far, all these three songs would be great entries. Just depending on the live performance, choose which one's the best. And you're good to go. I think we're doing a good job so far. There's one more to go, though, so let's check one out right now. The final song that I need to listen to is by the five-head group, High Five. Honestly, those the names they come up with for like the groups are a bit cringy in a way. I mean, not that the kids will care, but for me, it's like, yeah, I get it. High five, because they're with five. Yeah, it's basically a formula that they use. It's okay. The song is called Because I Know. Well, I don't know how this will be, so I will gladly find out how it is. So, without further ado, let's play! Okay. I hope this gluing won't be through the entire thing, because that usually annoys me in music. Still there. It sounds like this is underproduced, like the voices sound way softer, like less loud, compared to the other songs, compared to the backing track. But it doesn't matter for the live performance, because you can tweak that easily. Yeah. Yeah, the thing annoys me already, like that's been there from the start. But this is more the song that you would usually see with us, like, use a very basic beat. Go ahead, kids. Yeah. This one doesn't really impress me. It doesn't have the energy either. It doesn't have an exciting beat, or it doesn't really have an exciting structure. This is what we've been doing the last couple of years, so if we choose this, I'm gonna be a bit mad. Because the other songs actually sound like they put some effort in. This one sounds like, oh yeah, this will do. And again, nothing against the kids, right? They're having a time of their lives. And they'll probably will on stage as well. Yes, no. That's as simple as we're gonna get it. This is what we did before. This is not what we should do in the future. We've proven now that it doesn't work, and it's been annoying me, like, the past couple of years, how lazy some of the songs were. This is one of those lazy songs. The other ones actually sound like they have some thought put into them. This one doesn't. And nothing against High Five. They had a great time, I think, in the video clip. They will have a great time on the stage as well. This is just not it. I'm very sorry. Yeah. Let's wrap up the video. And there you have it. Yes, I listened to all the four contenders for our entry for Junior Eurovision 2022. Who's my favorite? Who's my least favorite? I mean, I think I kind of already shown it throughout the video. But in fourth place, easily is High Five. It's nothing against the kids yet again, but it's just the most lazy attempt out of all of the four of them. So yeah, I'm not gonna back that one at all. If it wins, good for the guys, but it is such a downgrade from all of the other songs. Like, there is a massive gap in how good they are. In third, I'll go for Luna La Festa. It's a fun song. It's really cool, structured. They did a little bit more than it would usually do compared to last year and stuff. I'm just a bit afraid that her voice on its own will not shine as much with the other songs, because it might feel a bit more empty than it can be. But hey, if she proves me wrong, I will gladly back that entry. Like, literally my top three, I will gladly back. Yeah, second place goes to Infinity with Never Ever. It's just a fun little song. I think it would do decently at Eurovision, so. And their voices sounded very coherent, very good together. So it's also a massive plus. And then on number one, mixed up with It Doesn't Matter. It's just the most interestingly structured song. It has the most out there beat, I would say, as well. So I think that if you really want to grab the audience, you need to go for this one. It's as simple as that. It just has the most intriguing beat. Now, of course, we all need to see them all perform live. Like, maybe some of them won't be as good live as they are on a studio cut, and that might be the difference between winning or not. Because that was basically what happened last year, I think. The girl that won in the end was definitely the best vocalist. So yeah, we'll be looking forward to see that, and after that we'll just, like, I don't know. I hope it's just not going to be the fourth song. It's just lazy. Anyways, let me know how you would rank these songs in the comments down below. And keep in mind, everyone has their own opinion. If you think the fourth song is the best, go ahead. You are free to do so, and I applaud you for that as well. And keep it in mind that these are kids, right? So keep everything respectful. Keep being respectful towards another, and yeah, make sure to like the video, make sure to subscribe to the channel, make sure to leave a comment, because that all helps me tremendously. We're heating up for Junior Eurovision. I hope more and more and more songs get released. And after that, we're already gonna roll slowly into Adult Eurovision again. And I'm so excited for that. I miss doing these. This is what I love doing. Just analyzing the songs is what I love doing so much more. Like, I made that video from the Netherlands. It was quite fun, but it's not really what I desire to be doing. So, yeah, this is way more fun for me. And hopefully for you guys as well. So, I'll see you in the next video. But for me, today, goodbye.